So one of the benefits of the Lean Scholar Program is networking with other officers who have actually integrated science into their police departments. And with that collaboration, we get a body of knowledge that we can use and then share and disseminate. One thing that Obed and I have done is we've co-founded the American Society of Evidence-Based Policing. And one thing that we try to do is bridge that gap between academics, researchers, community members, and everyone who has a vested interest in policing. And it's part of that narrative that we're trying to translate, communicate between the research and the frontline officer so we can actually integrate real data and real science into policing.
So one of the things we, in the most simplistic way to say is, if you got a problem in your neighborhood, whether you have something going on in your organization, and you want to solve that problem, and you want to use scientific research in solving that problem, you want the pracademics, people associated with the American Society of Evidence-Based Policing, and other pracademics coming up with those solutions in solving that problem.
One of the things the LEAD Scholars Program has helped me is to understand the importance of evidence-based research and the partnership between a local police department and a university. It was kind of hard to put that together because I didn't know what it looked like. But then the last few months, I was able to get with Loyola University as well as my department, New Orleans Police Department, and build a collaboration, a research partnership, and bridging that together. And we're going to be working on, hopefully in the near future, a study of homicides clearance rates in New Orleans, looking at new measures and new strategies and ways we can rise the clearance rates in New Orleans.
I've taken multiple activities that while being a LEAD Scholar. The first thing I would like really just to talk about is my research initiative with the Mentoring Arts and Youth Program. That program really focuses on building relationships with minority youth and also teaching them skill sets to be successful. Through that program, I've been able to really do some publishing on a national level and have some conversations on a national level as a LEAD Scholar. And so being a LEAD Scholar has really elevated me from to an executive standpoint to really talk about things nationally, things that I'm doing in my local community.
So if you look at the goal of law enforcement in general, we're trying to obviously better ourselves, advance our profession, work within the streets that we know have effective and the most safest outcomes for our citizens and also for our law enforcement officers. Working with the LEAD Scholar Program, what you have is a collective body of research practice that has been integrated and adopted already, and more importantly, measured. And the successful interventions is what we want to pick from the LEAD Scholars. We want to use that information and we want to disseminate it out. So we're not just keeping the information internally, but we're sharing it with the broad body of law enforcement across the states.
Well, for one, it allows a platform to talk about issues that are going on within our community, and not only our community, that is affecting society across the country. It has allowed myself to be a representative of my organization on a national level, but with a very reputable organization such as NIJ. So it's been very beneficial. It allows us to be in the room and have conversations and to move really that conversation forward from a local level to a national level.